My name is Gulam Mohammed Sheikh. I'm from Baroda, India. I have worked in a variety of mediums, but mainly in painting, especially in oil. Of late, I have worked in watercolor. We also dabbled in photography because we had camera and also made images or prints, which were a combination of digital print, that is inkjet print, and watercolor. It could also be animated. And when there was an exhibition on my late friend Bhupen Khakkar, I even thought of making a sculpture. So these are all media, all kinds of techniques which are available to us. I would like to try my hand. All these are part of the educational system, especially in Baroda. 1970s, I began to explore the context of life being lived. That means our own life. But it didn't sort of stop at where you lived, but also places where you have visited, you have traveled. And so one felt, how can one bring in all these experiences together? So the idea of the multiple, or the multiple situations, or to belong to multiple situations, also emerged out of that. But at the same time, living in India, as one knows, that people live in multiple times, not only multiple situations. And eventually, this kind of a contextual history opened up the geography of life. I chanced upon a map. I have been looking for maps and I wanted a world map. In fact, I wanted to do something on that scale. It was a 13th century map of the world collapsed of Mappa Mundi. I liked the idea, and the digital technology helped because we could use it and make multiple versions of it. But my mind still remained with my hand. My head and hand somehow prevailed over me. So any print that I made, it was a digital print, I did some little interjection with watercolor or some such thing. I wanted also a dialogue of sort. And then I brought images from different parts of the world, different traditions, put them together and kept on doing that. So in a way, it is configuring the world, perhaps even remapping the world, perhaps even entering into the world and making it change. And this preoccupation has produced the kind of results, you know, in the last few years, in the form of a number of digital prints, in the form of a digital video, and I'm still engaged in that. I have visited the sites, I've seen the Biennale, and I thought it would be worthwhile making an effort to respond to the place. So I came here and looked around and saw a few places, went to a spin ball, went to paper house and all that. In fact, it has to work with something specific. So we started digitally put together some of the images that I thought I could use. And to be specific, this is a painting of Jaipur school and it is a painting of acrobats. So I thought that I could perhaps use that acrobat and give it a new context. Change the meaning, perhaps give it another dimension, put it in the contemporary context. This is an 18th century painting and I wanted to bring it to our time. So then I started imagining images that would go along with the map. Because it involves exploration, which means some kind of a great risk and wonderment. But at the same time, it means colonialism. It also means some kind of a belief system that you have. So I thought that it would be interesting to come, bring this together, and I began to imagine Vasco da Gama as an iconic figure on the one side, and also a kind of an anti-colonial figure as Mahatma Gandhi. So looking around images of the contemporary time, the Mughal painter had painted images of foreigners visiting India. And this is since 16th century. So I thought that it sort of matches the historical time. And so I thought that perhaps I could combine the image of the traveler along with Vasco da Gama. And then also think of other images. So in a way, it is like a kind of an icon. but I have imagining as two large images and the large map in the middle. And then there will be number of images which will be all spread around. But literally, you know, places that belong to different periods of time. There is a Vasco da Gama church, there is also there are a number of 19th century buildings, there are also contemporary buildings, but also you have the fantastic trees around. This is what makes Kochi, and also the sea, surrounded by sea. What better? You can think of something quite amazing in that. So I thought of putting my acrobat in an area where people gather. And we found a square where people sort of go for walks. And they have number of trees. There are lots of trees around. And I would like to use that thing. And in order to, in fact, open a dialogue with the people who come to visit the site, my images of acrobats might perhaps be placed there floating.